Good morning. Before service 174. 174. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Almighty, loving, and gracious Father, we come before you today, full with thanks, full with our faith, but dear Lord, we shall come full with thankfulness, because we come to celebrate the life of our dear Lord, someone who has been a part for many of our lives, someone who has been a part for some of our lives, and someone who has been a part of the congregation, the community, this fellowship of life. And today, we want to say thank you. Thank you that we could experience a life with you, albeit shortened, we say. But dear Lord, we want to say thank you. Thank you for allowing us to come and be here. We did not arrange this, it was through you that we have come to bid farewell. And farewell for only a little while. Because we look forward to the day when we see your son, when we can be reunited once again. And dear Lord, may that serve as comfort in our hearts and souls. That the separation is only beginning. Soon we will be reunited with all our loved ones, with all your children in the realm of the world, when we will sing that new song. And then we will understand. For now, we ask for your strength, we ask for your guidance, we ask for your comfort, we ask for your peace, so that we may come to that understanding sooner rather than later. That we can come to trust and confide in you fully and completely, and praise you for your strength. Dear Lord, again, we just want to sing your glory and might, because you do so much for us. And although we can ask questions, but why have you allowed this moment to come to fruition? We know, dear Lord, that your love has never left us. Your love has never left us here on the other side. Your love will never be those who go into the world. Because your love supersedes all my life. Your love transcends all dimensions. Your love, dear Lord, can be felt wherever we proclaim your name, wherever we look towards you, whenever we come towards you. Your love can be felt, experienced, and then also shared. And dear Lord, today may we experience that love. May we experience that comfort and that peace. And then we don't want to just keep it for ourselves. We want to go out and share it. Share it with those whom we know. Share it with those whom we don't know. It doesn't matter to us. Because you have given us each. And we want to spread your love. We want to radiate your love, your joy, your peace, and your hope. And in everything that we do, we want to have a blessing. We also connect with our bearers of blessing, the Lord, apostles, our apostle has shared his condolences with the family, and he reminds us that he thinks of us and keeps us in his prayers. Dear Lord, we also pray for those whom Uncle Sammy will meet on the other side. We pray that that may be a blessed encounter, that it may serve to once again fill their hearts and souls with your love, with your peace. Now, dear Lord, many of us come here, and we do not always have the answers, but through your Spirit, we ask that you may give us exactly what we need, as a believing family, as loved ones, as those who come to support, as a congregation in this morning. We ask that you give each and every one of us what we need, so that we can continue to fight the good fight, and praise you all our days. Be with us now in these few moments. We pray this in your most holy name. Amen.
Amen.
My dear family, dear congregation, our word this morning is out of the book of James, James 5, verse 13. Is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is anyone cheerful? Let him sing songs. In Afrikaans, the proof is faith, vers 13. As daar iemand onder julle wat lê, laat hom bid. As iemand op rent, Open the red, Lord, Lord, Salvation. You can be seated at the Father. An impact on us. in some form or another, in some way or another. And we also come to support you, the family, and the loved ones, those who knew him much better, on a more personal and intimate level, those who spent a lot more time with him, so you could see a lot of his shortcomings, but you also saw a lot of the good. And so we also can come today to draw strength and come from the only one who can keep us back, our Lord and Savior. No one else can fill that hole that's been in. That separation that we have to deal with, I suppose it's something we deal with until we all meet again. But the Lord can help us cope. He can help us cope with granting us the comfort of him. And we don't have to imagine that blessed are those who they will be comforted. He will comfort us, and he comforts us today. He comforts you today. And not only today. Today, we're making a big fuss about the sermon and about the comfort that the Lord will share with you, but into the future, when you become a little bit more quieter, then you will experience those real moments of separation. When you sit at the family table on a special day, a special celebration, and you see that chair that you just sit at, is no more full with pain. When you experience special experiences that you and him share together, and you realize, well, now it's just you on this side. Those days will be done. Those moments will be done. But may today comfort, the peace, the joy in reflecting on his life, in reflecting on the word that has been chosen through the Holy Spirit, may it serve as a comfort and strength, especially during those times. We maybe look at our Bible word and we see it's two contrasting things. If you suffer, let him pray. If you are happy and cheerful, let you sing songs. Ultimately, it all comes to us coming closer to God. Whether we are sad, whether we are happy, but let us come closer to you. When you are sad, I will help you. When you are happy, I rejoice with you. And we look at maybe his joy. Going into the beyond, a former rector of mine used to mention, paint this image of the airport arrivals and departures. On the one side, the departure terminal, there is sadness because someone is saying farewell, goodbye. On the other side of the arrivals terminal, there is lots of joy because someone is coming back, or someone is coming who we haven't really seen in a long time. And from the Sammy, he goes into the realms of the beyond, and you can imagine the joy of him seeing love. Seeing brother, sister, parents, many other loved ones who he met along his journey here on the earth, and you can imagine the joy the Lord loves, the joy that he can experience and share with him in that community. And then we look also at the joy of him not having any physical illness. He suffered for a while, and that body has now been left behind. That body that had all the ailments that suffered from strokes, that's been left behind. That is not his concern anymore. His joy is now just to focus on his soul. And so that brings us to know that someone who we know, you know how he suffered. You know what he had to endure. You know the battles he faced, even in terms of him wanting to do this, but not being allowed to, because of the restrictions on the physical body. And now that is all left behind. And so that again is a source of comfort and joy to you and I, to know that that is not something you need to worry about being done. You look at our sorrow and you see sorrow. You see tears, you see prayer. and it is not nice to see that. But it is mainly there because of the love that we share, the love that you and Uncle Sammy share, the love that we share together as a family, love as a congregation also. And I say as a congregation, we know the many congregations Uncle Sammy moved in. The mission work he did from where he was born to the point of moving this side, the many he touched along the way, the many that touched him. And because of that interaction, of that relationship, he said, but again, our comfort is drawn from the fact that because Jesus overcame death, because he overcame sin, we have an opportunity to look forward to celebrating this. We have an opportunity to look forward to embracing once again. And we pray that it may be so. We pray that the Lord will come and fetch us, and take all those in the realms of the beyond, and take us to the heavenly home that has been prepared for us. And that remains our goal. That remains our number one desire. Because it is through that the home of God that we can be together. And once we are together in that resurrection body, there will be no worries or concerns. So, we know Uncle Sammy did not, it was his wish to not have an obituary read out, which made my life a little bit tougher, a bit difficult. But so I reached out because I am not Uncle Sammy. I met Uncle Sammy the first time at your birthday celebration last year, and then the next time I would meet him would be in hospital. And the last time we met him was served with the police priest and deacon. We dropped up his bed, he was sleeping, and the priest woke him up. And I don't know if you woke him up gently, because immediately when he woke up he started crying. But in that moment I thought Uncle Sammy could not respond, couldn't speak or express what was on his heart. But I hold on to that memory because it was a tear, and I believe it was a tear of joy. And the fact that he would have the opportunity in that state he was in, he had the opportunity to celebrate the body and blood of Jesus Christ. He had the opportunity to partake of that which is the fullness of God, that power, that strength, that grace that he would have been offered and being able to partake of, he could experience in that moment. And so we served him, and it was a wonderful moment, and like I said, that is a memory I would hold on to. But some of the brothers did share some thoughts, which I asked them for, and I'm going to share a few snippets of what they shared. It is with a heavy heart that we bid farewell to our beloved Deacon Sammy. He was truly a God-fearing man and a loving family man. He's dedicated to God's work and his guidance for the young members, especially the young ministers of Erica East, have left an indelible mark on all of us. Deacon Sammy's vision and foresight have contributed to the betterment of our congregation, and his impact will be felt for generations to come. As we mourn the loss of one of our pioneers, let us also celebrate the remarkable legacy he leaves behind. To the Arries family, may you find peace and comfort in the memories of Deacon Sammy's love and devotion. Let us honor his memory by continuing to uphold the values. I knew Sammy well as a friend. Sammy was a good Samaritan, always willing to help anyone in need, and it was never a burden for me. He found great joy in helping others. This beautiful characteristic of him is what our friends are. I'm sure as I read this, you can all relate your own personal experiences with Uncle Sammy. I'm sitting here thinking about Sammy Arries. I worked with his dad, an uneducated man. Couldn't read or write for it, but his faith and love for God's work and God's people knew no boundaries. And this was very much passed on to Sammy. Sammy and his brother Gabo been working on mission trips for a very long time, and Sammy was never one to ask for dinner. Everything he did for the Lord was because of what his father taught him since he was his youth days. But one more. Sammy was stubborn for supper. He couldn't change his mind once he made his mind up. He was a good person with a good heart. People loved Sammy as he had a nice sense of humor, and people always enjoyed his company. We used to do mission work all over and used to teach the children how to play the recorder or music. I knew Sammy as a God-fearing person, and he never held back to help me. He was someone I knew about and learned about from both naturally and spiritually. So I suppose, and maybe, like I said, you can relate to some of the experiences we've had with him over the years. And I think one thing is definitely obvious for me, as a person who did not know Uncle Sammy, he was quite consistent. Everyone mentioned how he loved to help people, how he was willing to help people. Many mentioned could be quite stubborn from time to time. And he mentioned how he also loved to serve, especially during mission work. And yeah, those memories you will hold on to for a long time. Maybe at this point we can sing as a congregation before we continue with the sermon. Is it quiet? It's quiet. It's quiet.
Collection 315.
Service, I came across this word early on in the week, not done as I have not lived, done what I'm supposed to do according to the will of God. But there are three specific themes he speaks about. And it's very simple things. Number one, speak with love. Number two, serve the poor. And number three, be wholly dedicated to God. And maybe if we can relate to Sammy, the way he lived his life, how he did certain things to those three points. Speak with love. I can't aggregate on his behalf because I don't know. But what I have heard, as mentioned, he's enjoyed making a few jokes. He enjoyed making people laugh from time to time. When you are about sharing the joy, there's a little bit of love behind that motivation. Right? So maybe in that way he can say he spoke with love. Then, so before, pretty obvious, he was always willing to help. Even when it was inconvenient for me, he was willing to help. And as one of the brothers said, he never asked for anything this time. It was never a burden for you. Maybe it was a burden to do with the family. Because sometimes when you are part of the family, what you do affects those who are with you. And so you've done that too in support of him. You too have given a sacrifice to help others. And may that continue. May that continue to be for you and I. We're all connected here. That we always want to serve our brother and our sister. It is the mission that Jesus gave us to spread his gospel, to love God above all things and our neighbor as ourselves. And then to be wholly dedicated to God. Again, I reflect on the mission work that he did and how many congregations he was involved in where he taught one or the other to play an instrument, to sing a hymn. All those things may seem a little bit small, but from that, the Lord could develop many other things. And that is up to the Lord. But this message of James from the entire book speaks about just being wholly dedicated to God in whatever way possible, whether it means coming to a divine service, whether it means supporting my East Queensland Church, whether it means supporting a fellow brother or sister in a time of need, physically or maybe through prayer. We think of our motto for the year, prayer works, and part of that teaching is about interceding on behalf of my fellow brother and sister. Praying for those who are finding it difficult to continue, who see no light at the end of the tunnel, that we reach out to God on their behalf. We do not always know what one or the other is going through, but we know someone who does, and that is God. And so when we can speak to him on their behalf, it is a manner in which we speak to our message of prayer. We speak to helping and serving our neighbor, but also in that being dedicated to God. Because again, coming back to that first one, love God above all, and your neighbor as yourself. And when we come to God in our suffering today, we say, Lord, grant us strength, grant us peace, grant us comfort. Give us that which we need in order to continue to shine your light, in order to continue to be dedicated to you, in order to continue to be able to serve and help just as our dear Lord. And then also, I spoke about the suffering we've seen today, love is so great that tomorrow the same school has the opportunity to come to the altar of God. Let him have the mercy and come to those where the new sacrament is in himself, and you get you for that away. Again, I reflect on my last opportunity I had to serve in Holy Communion, and that tear of joy that rolled down the street. Tomorrow I see you standing for those same years of joy, full of love, full of peace, full of everything to know that God will remain with you and he will remain with us too. And when we are going through our different emotions, our contrasting emotions, we know he will always come to you because he opens up his arms to us and he says, come, I will help you, I will guide you, and ultimately he will lead us towards a goal of our faith. Amen.
Amen.
So that is our message. That is also the funeral of our dear Michael, dear Deacon Michael Arries. And so now I ask the congregation to please stand. It is a time to make your service, and I will now surrender the body. I now return the mortal body to the earth with the words. Earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Soul and spirit, however, I commend to the love of Jesus Christ, who shall guard or bring it until the resurrection to eternal life. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
We can now close with prayer in the ministry. Almighty and loving God, again, dear Lord, we come to you with hearts full of thanks, full with happiness also, although we are sad, to know that our dear deacon, our dear brother, our dear father, grandfather, our dear friend, who had an impact on our lives in many various ways, we are thankful for that impact. We are thankful to be able to have known. We are thankful to have been able to be in his company. And dear Lord, we now want to ask that you may take care of him. Where he goes, where he is, that your hand of love may continue to be with him. Be with him and those who may be united in the realms of the kingdom. And that together with us, dear Lord, you may continue to help us to prepare for the coming of Jesus. Because when Jesus comes again, we will all be reunited. And we ask, dear Lord, that you may instill within us that will, that desire to want to do better, to want to love better in a manner that reflects your love toward yourself. In a manner that reflects that we want to speak with love, that we want to serve those around us, serve our neighbors, serve the poor, serve the needy, serve each other, and we also, in that, continue to express our dedication, our devotion through observing the congregation, through the way we carry ourselves at school, through the way we carry ourselves at our workplace, that we may always demonstrate that we are your children and that we have no continuity here on this earth, but we are working towards a common goal. Now, dear Lord, again, we pray for your comfort and strength on family, loved ones, and all those connected. And we ask that your hand of love may cover us. And should you send your son out, please do not pass any one of us by, but accept us all in grace. Pray this in your most holy name. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Thank you.
maybe not physically, but with other things. And also thank you on the undertakers for providing a dignified service as we bid farewell to our dear Uncle Sam. As an exit team, I maybe ask the forebears to come forward, those who are going to take Uncle Sammy out of the church. We will sing as a congregation out of the council. In this pamphlet it says 179, but it is 180 in the hymn.
Thank you. Hi everyone, I would just like to say thank you for live streaming. I know you couldn't be here, but I send my love and greetings to everyone near to you, and I would like to say thank you. Thank you.